Hi, welcome to MooMooMath. Today we're going to talk about properties of exponents. The first property is called the product of powers property. We've got a to the m times a to the n is equal to the a to the m plus n. So we're adding our exponents when we multiply bases. The second property is called the power of powers property. We've got a to the n all raised to the nth power. That is equal to a to the m times n. And we're going to multiply the exponents. The third one is the power of a product property. That's when you have the product AB, all quantity to the mth power. We can rewrite that as a to the m times b to the m. The fourth property would be called the zero exponent property. That's when a base a is raised to the zero power. That is always equal to 1, as long as a is not 0. The fifth one is the quotient of powers property. We've got a over m divided by a to the nth. That's equal to the a to the m minus n. In other words, we subtract our exponents when you divide like bases. Now let's run through a couple examples. We're going to start with a product of powers property. The first example is 4 to the second times 4 to the fourth. Well, 4 is our like base, so that's going to be 4 to the 2 plus 4, or 4 to the 6th power. A second example of the product of powers would be a to the 6th times a to the 3rd. Since we're multiplying like bases, we're going to add the exponents. That will give us a to the 9th power. The second property is the power of a power. The first one we're going to look at is x to the 5th all raised to the 2nd power. Well, what we do there is we multiply the exponents. So that's going to give us x to the 10th power. A second example of that one would be 5 to the negative 2nd all raised to the 3rd. Although the exponent is negative, we still multiply those two exponents together, and that gives us 5 to the negative 6th power. The third property is the power of a product property. The first one we're going to look at is 4 times a squared b cubed, that quantity all raised to the 5th power. Well, what we're going to do is take that 5 and distribute it to every element in the parentheses. So that will give us a 4 to the 5th power, a squared to the 5th power, which we know we multiply those exponents. So that results in a to the 10th. And then b to the 3rd all to the 5th. We know we multiply the exponents, so that becomes b to the 15th. You can use your calculator if you want to raise 4 to the 5th power and get the coefficient, or you can just leave it as 4 to the 5th as the coefficient. The second example of a power of a product property would be x to the 4th, y to the 7th, all raised to the 3rd power. We would then distribute that 3 to both exponents. And we're raising to a power, we're multiplying exponents. So that will be x to the 12th times 7, y to the 21st. And that's the example, the zero exponent property. No matter what you are raising to the zero power, it's always going to be 1. So the example we're going to look at is x cubed all to the 0 power. Well, when we multiply exponents, that's going to give us x to the 0, and anything to the 0 power is 1. So x to the third to the 0 becomes 1. And the final property is the quotient of powers property. So we're looking at division. Quotient always means to divide. Let's start with x to the 8th divided by x to the 6th. We subtract our exponents, so it's going to be x to the 8 minus 6, or x squared is your final answer. The second example would be x to the 5th on top divided by x to the 8th on the bottom. We still subtract the exponents, so it will be x to the 5 minus 8, which is x to the negative 3rd. You could also rewrite that as 1 over x cubed. And those are the 5 properties of exponents. I hope this video has been helpful.